Guys, we are going to talk about football numbers in the Tusker versus Kakamega Homeboys game. Welcome and listen to the technical analysis by Uchi.
So game ya Tusker versus Kakamega Homeboys ilichezwa kule Machakos, and Kakamega Homeboys are going to be the ones in red, Tusker the ones in yellow. Now Tusker set up in a 4-4-2 formation. Tulikuwa na Joseph Ochuka, former Bandari, at the post. Then tulikuwa na right back, that was Odhiambo.
Collins.
Then center, Collins Odhiambo.
Mm-hmm.
Center backs ilikuwa Mike Ibwage na Charles Momanyi, the captain. Then at left back,
George
we
Kadu.
Have George Kadu himself. Midfield partnership, tulikuwa na Crispin Erambo, who played at 6.
Mm-hmm.
Then we had Odoyo at 8.
Mm-hmm.
Then in the wings, we had Balecho Naman on the right and Oduor Mike on the left.
Mm-hmm.
Up front, tulikuwa na Ryan Ogam and what's his name?
Shafan Siwa.
Shafan Siwa.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Tusker walikuwa the beginning of the game, first half, they were the better team.
Mm-hmm.
They had most of the ball.
Mm-hmm.
They tried to, at least we could see some instances playing from the back. From the data, we could see most of their goal kicks zilikuwa zinaenda short from Mochuka to either Kibwage or Charles Momanyi. Also, they utilized their wingers quite often. We could see Balecho and Michael Duor. They were hugging the touchline a lot. So walikuwa wana move the ball wakiwa karibu na touchline most of the time. And Crispin Erambo was tasked with the work ya ku break opponent's play. Now Odoyo was the one who progressed play from their half to the other half ya Kakamega Homeboys. Now the game ended 2-2, and all I can say ni kuwa all goals actually that were scored in the games, they were transition goals, mistakes that were made by the defender. Now Tusker went 2-0 up in the first half. The ball was in the final third of Kakamega Homeboys. Yeah.
So Ochi, anytime walikuwa wana look utilize their center backs a lot, their wingers a lot, sindio?
Uh-huh.
So anytime they utilized their wingers,
mm-hmm.
Did they have a 4-2-4 formation, or what kind of formation did they use when utilizing their wingers?
Now when they utilized their wingers, they had a 4-2-4 formation. With the four, the back line, ilibaki vile iko hivo. Then Crispin, Erambo, and Odoyo, they moved somewhere up on mbele to occupy that space. Then Ryan Ogam na Siwa Shafan waka move pia forward. How waka join in attack. So they had that 4-2-4 formation when they were attacking. So the goal that they scored for the first goal at Tusker, scored by Ryan Ogam, the defenders were... Kakamega Homeboys actually had the ball. I think the goalkeeper was passing the ball to the left back. The person who was playing on the left back. Then he miscontrolled the ball. Ball ikaanguka kwa miguu ya Siwa Shafan. Then Shafan passed one touch to Ryan Ogam and he finished. So that was the first goal for Tusker. Second goal was scored in a similar manner again. The play was, I think, on the right wing. Bungoja. So ball came from the right wing. That was courtesy of that time Balecho and Odwar had switched the wings. Balecho came to the left hand, Odoyo kaenda right hand. So the ball again came from the right wing, Tusker FC. It came into the box and they scored their second goal. Now what is interesting about this Tusker game ni the fact that they came from leading by 2 goals. Now wakakuwa conceded, well, they conceded 2 goals and the game ended in a draw. Now, the same way ilikuwa nimesema, Tusker walikuwa na utilize sana their defense partnership kwa build up. So ball ilifika hapa, actually Tusker defenders had a lot of time ku clear hiyo ball, but because of the high press, because Kakamega Homeboys pressed so high up the line, in a fact that when these defenders, instead of clearing one time, but walikuwa nataka ku build from the back, Momanyi ended up losing the ball to the attacking player Kakamega Homeboys. And they equalized. The second goal happened in the same fashion. Again, they were trying to play from the back. Charles Momanyi and Kibwage lost the ball to the attackers of Kakamega Homeboys, and they scored their second goal. So game ilikuwa na mistakes mingi from defenders kwa Tusker side. And Njoro mina that ni because How are they don't know how to control play when they are leading. Tusker FC wako na hiyo challenge sana ku control play kama wako mbele. Na pia their midfield partnership ya Erambo na Odoyo ilikuwa overwhelmed by the midfield three ya Kakamega Homeboys. So that is how the game went on in Machakos. Uliza tu maswali.
Maswali, hata mimi niko na swali.
So, Ochi, umesema the biggest problem with Tusker, the way you view Tusker from the games you've watched them, the biggest problem you have with them ni their lapses in concentration,
right? Exactly.
So the defenders wanna lose ball haraka sana
araka
when they are pressed.
When they are
so
pressed.
Do you think it's a tactical problem or is it an individual player problem, according to you?
Okay, mimi naweza sema ni individual player problem because as much as coach anaweza peana tactical setup, you as an individual player lazima umake your decision. We are ahead, tumekuwa pressed high, ball is in our final defensive third. So what is the best thing to do as a defender? Pura, tuende mbele. Watu wataongea, coach ataongea, but at the end of the day, si umesaidia team joro?
Kweli. Exactly. Alafu, so, I have another question. Do you feel like, is it compulsory that we keep, we are ahead and we are in the second half, maybe in the 60th minute, we keep on trying building from the back, yet we can make sure that you saw what, I'll use an Europe example. Arsenal were ahead 2-1 with a red card. So they made sure the ball did not stay at their box. Any instant they got the ball, yani chance yote walikuwa wanapata ball, walikuwa wana make sure wapi? So,
imeenda mbele.
Yeah, when ball imetoka hapo kwa hiyo nini yao.
Exactly.
So, I feel like at some point, you know that Erambo is good on the ball. At some point, Odoyo, he's a ule midfielder and a bonda watu kabisa, sindio?
Exactly.
So, I feel like having these two players, kwa nini na msha lead nini, waongeze tu responsibility, waambie, si lazima tu nini, to commit a lot of fouls, kwa nini yetu, kwa half yetu, let's make the sure the ball tumewanda kwa pressure from ata hapa hivi kwa hii second third kwenda mbele. To make sure the
ball haifiki kwa defensive third yetu.
Ball haikai hapa.
Exactly.
Because if we can make sure that the ball in haitoki hapa, we can have a better chance ya win that game.
Yeah, win
because
game.
Bottling a 2-goal lead in 2 games consecutively, the coach anafaa anze kujiuliza maswali. What am I doing wrong during the second half in both in those matches? Nona. Alafu, make sure, umeona imekata, make sure ume substitute Balecho mapema. Umeona, maybe, for instance, he's always very good kwa attack, but defensively maybe ako, maybe 50 hapo. So, if you feel like, ongeza midfielder mwingine, leta midfielder mwingine mwenye atakuja, asaidi Odoyo, maybe if unaona, energy imeisha kidogo, kuboost the team momentum.
Boost the team momentum.
Exactly.
That is true. Actually, we saw some point in the game, but though I feel ilikuwa late sana, they substituted Balecho, they brought in Fabian, wakaleta Fabian, and he tried to change the game, but ilikuwa too late. Homeboys had already come back from a 2-goal down, waka equalize.
So, I feel it is very wrong for a team to have a 2 lead, na mnaenda kwa game, mnaenda kufaitia a draw, then you are 2-0 leading in the first half. I feel like it's a lot of pressure kujiekelea, na ni pressure mnaweza fanya nini? Mnaweza avoid. Unacheki?
Exactly.
I don't know what Tusker will do, but I think they really need those points, because when Gor Mahia comes na ndio competitor wao,
exactly.
Gor Mahia will not be wasting, hata kuwa napoteza points kama mingi.
Na kuna police pia, usisahau police.
Hai.
Exactly. Aundi so police
ligi.
Na Goru wakirudi.
Aundi wenye ligi. Achana, Goru nimesema juu Goru wanashindanga 1-0. Unaona? 1-0, 1-0, 2-0. Sinajua Goru, it's not a high scoring team.
Yeah, yeah.
Because they are very good defensively. Unaona? Alafu, forward line yao sahi, kwanza haina makali ya umala. I don't think they'll be getting a lot of goals. So, I think the Indo chance wangetumia Tusker before police come back and do wonders and with Gor Mahia.